Hey everyone, it's Designer Lily here. Today I am so excited to show you a collaborative whiteboard challenge that I did with a student of mine. It's been a while since I've done one of these and I'm extra excited to show you because from my work experience as a product designer, some of the steps I've done here are gonna change and my framework is also better than before. So if you watch my other videos, great, but I personally think this video is gonna be one of the best on my channel so far. So let's get into it. This prompt was given by a relatively well-known tech company who I'll call Work. And obviously some of the notes and wording has been tweaked a little bit to kind of hide who the company is. Overall, the structure is the same. And the way I solve this problem is going to be the same. This framework has been presented by the company where introduction, brainstorm, MVP, success metrics, and wrap up is already labeled. So they really just want to see how the candidate navigates with the information they have and then lead this session. The way they've labeled this information is a little odd. For example, they say the goal is that you're participating in an internal project with a PM and two software engineers, and you need to define an MVP and launch quickly and collect data to validate the solution. It's not really a goal, it's more like the context. And then the product pitch is helping people in college find jobs. The only somewhat significant thing here that's presented that's new is that there's 15% of resumes on Work that are from job seekers, specifically in college. No data of why they want to target those college students, but it's a significant portion of the user base. I went ahead and noted the information and put it on the side to properly label them and organize them in a way that helps me think. Basically, constraints of 3 weeks, PM and two engineers, MVP, launch quick, collect data. I mean, that's very standard product development process. Then the goal is to help people get jobs that are in college, and a significant portion, which is 15%, and we want to increase user feedback in some way, which is really, really vague. Not really that helpful. But basically, it says that because this app is backed by a big business that's already profitable and operating, they have more resources, and becoming profitable is not one of the important goals here. And I just wrote down some of the open questions that I would ask the interviewer. For example, why are we targeting these college students? What's the purpose? Is the goal to get more students to complete job registrations or actually fill more listings for companies that are on the site? Ultimately, it comes down to the fact that I'm not really clear on why we need to solve this problem as a business. And these are just some questions that I wrote here I would ask the interviewer as I'm thinking speaking out loud. Jumping into the brainstorm section, the interviewer did tell my student that a lot of the past candidates failed this section because they got caught up in this part and treated it as a workshop. And I think that's very common for a lot of designers who come from creative backgrounds like myself. We are very generative thinkers. And if you haven't worked in a tech data-driven environment, which is so far from what you have in a creative environment, then it's really hard to go past this part to the next steps because you don't have the experience of a proper product development culture. Again, because of what the company said, I knew that it was important we didn't spend too much time on this section, as I assumed what they really were looking for was seeing if you can take an idea and execute it. So the execution part is everything. And in tech, as we say, like, ideas are one of millions, but execution is everything. So whatever we come up here, it's really not that important because the ideas are probably going to be repetitive. I had the student use the blue sticky notes and I used the purple sticky notes to come up with ideas, and then we could vote on the ideas. So if I was interviewing, I would ask the interviewer to step in and collaborate with me to come up with ideas, and then we can both vote on those ideas. So after we came up with these ideas, I had each person take two votes and then vote on any idea. And these three ideas are what we dissected. I do realize this was missing before. The vote sticky got removed somehow, but it was there during the session. So the three ideas we landed on was swipe and match to talk and interview, speed interviewing, and then some kind of online job convention platform where companies can sponsor events. And as we talked through these ideas, we realized that in terms of MVP, none of these seemed feasible except the swipe to match to talk. Because if you do some kind of speed dating with a resume, how does that exactly work? You have to set up a video conference sort of call with integrations with camera, mic, with servers, and then also match schedules, and then have some kind of maybe security aspect. You know, you're making sure that people coming in to the servers are not hackers or people that you actually want to talk to. So it just became really complicated. And the online job convention platform is even more complicated, and there's a reason why Google and Zoom hasn't built this yet. So after we discussed the ideas, we went ahead and moved into MVP, where we focus more of our time on. It's interesting that they put you can insert or paste sketches here, even though I knew this would have not made a difference at all. Because the interviewers are coming from more mature product backgrounds, This means that the companies they're typically used to, they'll have a process that's more mature and more focused on user journeys, task flows, user flows, etc. So the purpose of this section is to show your analytical thinking and sketching would slow you down, as well as the fact that you can convey the same concepts with just using these sticky notes as task flows. So what I ended up doing was breaking down task flows for student and company slash manager after registration. And this is on the assumption that one listing can only be marked hired for one person. For the first time experience of a student looking for a job after registration, they would allow location services, first job is shown, we have a small swiping tutorial, and then they can swipe either way and that's it. For a student who's coming back to find a job and they've already done this before, job is shown, swipes left or right, another job is shown, etc. For a student who has matched with a job, what happens is that the job is shown, they swipe right, and then they get a match notification that can be a pop-up or another message of some sort, and then they can book time with the company to make the first contact. With the company side, in terms of first time finding a candidate, after registration, they will create a job listing, fill availability to interview applicants, and then submit these two forms, and then a first candidate is shown, swiping tutorial, and they can swipe either way. And if they were to match with a candidate, the same thing would happen with a matched pop-up. The only difference is that they can review the resume of the candidate and then have a notification of when the candidate booked a time to interview with them. I realized after doing this task flow that booking time was a bit of a complex integration, because on the candidate side, they have to find time that the company is available for and then get some kind of signal of a book time. And then for the company side, they have to be notified that a candidate booked their time this time to show up. So that's something that's probably not going to be for P1, and I voiced that. So moving forward, this will be something that's later down the road. So that's perfectly normal as you're solving a problem to realize that the constraints means that there needs to be simpler solutions. That's just part of being a product designer. That often happens when you're working with a PM. And then that's why collaboration is important, because you have someone to bounce off those ideas and those thoughts with. And I think it's important to highlight that and speak about that as you're doing a whiteboard challenge. So diving into the success metrics, we could potentially measure the number of matches per listing on work versus the new app to see efficiency. But because the new app has less users, that will have to be accounted for. So maybe seeing how many job listing views are converted into applying and then converted into matches. Another one could be a number of booked interviews by the company on this new app versus what it was previously on work. And lastly, maybe a number of applicants that have been marked higher for listing. So how many matches are actually completed, and that could be the goal per quarter. I set aside these two metrics, monthly active users and retention, because they're not the most important things here, but usually for any new standalone B2C app, these are the most important metrics to watch out for. To wrap everything up here, the proposed solution is to create a simple swipe to match app between a company and a local candidate, and then offer a way for them to get each other's contact number, as well as the company being able to see the candidate's resume. The company can talk about their job listing with photos and text so that there's a little bit more of a storytelling aspect going on versus right now, all there is a standard job post listing. So summarize everything for P1, which is the MVP, we want to launch an app where a company and a local candidate can swipe to match with each other and allow the company to add photos and text information into their job listing to kind of give more of storytelling into why someone should work for them. And then candidates can also on their side upload their resume and photos. And once they're matched, the contact information will be revealed. Instead of before, where I talked about a booking mechanism, that's a little bit too much for MVP. So right now it's just contact information. Use another platform like a mail app to contact each other. For P2, we can introduce booking time to schedule a call, and then a company being able to mark the listing has been filled. An incentive why the company would want to return to mark a listing as filled is that perhaps it gets some kind of boosting where their next post will be shown to more candidates, so thereby increasing their chances of getting that position filled. For P3, we could allow candidates to set pay and location, and also have a content page slash section to teach candidates how to land jobs since they are just out of college. So that's my whiteboard challenge. This challenge is supposed to be 60 minutes timed, so in an actual interview setting, you would be talking and collaborating with someone while you're writing all of this down. So 60 minutes is pretty standard. I think we covered all the bases here. You know, in terms of 60 minutes, it goes by pretty quick. So if you all have any challenges like this, let me know in the comment section, like, what are you struggling with? what's something that really kind of trips you up about whiteboard challenges. Right now, I feel like whiteboard challenges are the lead code for designers in a way, because take-home challenges are becoming less and less of a thing. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button as well as that bell notification on. And if you have any prompts that you think could be interesting for next video, let me know in the comment section, and who knows, I might just do it. All right, everyone, until next time, bye.